abroad, she traveled.
And are women who made a difference. Acrylic Kids gift to our community.
A mother to be remembered. Louise Zorn, portrayed by Zach. It's just another day at the children's home. I get up, have some oatmeal, and go to school. Instead of coming home to my parents, who live all the way in California, and cannot take care of me, I come here to the children's home. Josephine Fletcher treats me like one of her own, as she does the 25 children that live here. She is like a mother to me. She knows the things that I like and just how to treat me. I am walking home from school with the girls, just like we always do. Today we decided to play kickball. We always have enough kids to play. After our kickball game, Miss Fletcher calls us in for our dinner consisting of a sandwich and a glass of milk or juice. I gobble down my sandwich quickly, then hurry upstairs with some girls to finish our ironing. We even had to iron the boys' shirts. I remember one time, some of the girls and I had hid the boys' shirts because we didn't want to iron them, and when Miss Fletcher found out, she gave us a good scolding. As my punishment, I couldn't take any Valentines to school, which was very embarrassing to me because everyone brought Valentines to school, and I couldn't bring any. After I had finished ironing, I went to my room, which I shared with a couple other girls, did my homework, and then went to bed. The community was so kind to us by providing us with free passes to the movies on Saturdays, and so we went to see a movie almost every Saturday. The people of La Crosse were very supportive of Miss Fletcher, and because of it, we never had to pay a penny for dentist or doctor appointments. Miss Fletcher would just call up the dentist and ask if they could take care of one child throughout their stay at the home, and they would agree. The community loved her so much, and they encouraged what she was doing. We could even go to the Y for free. The community provided us with numerous donations, but it wouldn't have meant as much without Miss Fletcher. Life at the children's home was pretty good, but there were some sad times. At school, people would say, "Oh, she lives at the children's home." And I didn't know what that meant, but I didn't like it. It made me feel embarrassed that I didn't have a place to stay with my parents. But on the other hand, the neighbor kids who would come to play wished that they lived at the home. I guess you always want what other people have. Well, as the months went by, we soon stumbled upon July, and that was a fun month. On the 4th of July, a very generous ice cream company would donate 5 large barrels of ice cream for us to eat. We would eat ice cream all day. It was a great treat. Then, later in the month, we had our annual lawn party. We always had to clean up our rooms and dress up because people from the community would come to see the home, and when they were there, they would make donations. There was a very wealthy man who didn't have any children of his own, so he would buy each one of us a Christmas present every year. We had to think and think about what we really wanted, and Miss Fletcher would send him the list of our presents. He would purchase them, and then on Christmas Eve, he would watch us open the gifts. I think it gave him much pleasure to see our faces light up. As for Thanksgiving, we always received a large turkey, and for birthdays, you always got a birthday cake. When I turned 18, I got a scholarship for college, and Miss Fletcher still allowed me to stay at the home. To help pay for college, I worked at the home as one of the adults instead of a child. I left the children's home when I graduated college, and sadly, it closed down in 1960. Miss Fletcher had worked there for 27 years. When I got married, Josephine came to my wedding, just like a real mother would. I now have 3 children, and I have taught them to be kind to others, and not to stare or treat someone different just because they have a problem or don't have parents. Josephine Fletcher has had a major influence on my life and how I act towards others. She was an amazing, kind-hearted mother. She just had the natural instinct of how to raise children. She taught me manners, responsibility, disciplined me when needed, and really took the time to get to know me. I still marvel at how she was so insightful with what each child needed. She has really paved the way for my future, and I have passed those values that she has taught me down to my children. I would just like to say thank you, Miss Fletcher, for everything. This podcast brought to you from La Crosse, Wisconsin by the Cooley Kids at Longfellow Middle School in conjunction with the League of Women.